I think one of the things that most people don't realize is that there's a difference between bouncing and exiting, and this is a tangent, but neither is particularly bad. When you think about the actual customer journey, people think of brands and products dozens of times before they buy, maybe even more. I mean, I know that I thought about moving to a different city for about 5 years off and on. Admittedly, part of it wasn't serious. And part of it was, but even looking at jobs to be done, frameworks, and how people buy mattresses, it takes them years. And you'd think that, oh, they bought this at Costco, it was the end of aisle, point of purchase, something like that. It's an impulse buy when it's actually not. So don't look at exit rates or ad bounce rates as particularly bad by themselves, especially when you understand what they mean. But to show you what I mean, go to behavior and all pages in this demo account, and we'll see both of those things right here. So, bounce rate, if you mouse over, basically it means, if somebody comes to your page and then no information gets pushed to Google Analytics, that is a bounce. So, give you a couple of examples of a bounce. Like somebody searches for something and it's like how to change my tire. This is a pretty cool, thing to search for. This is like good information. In reality, you're not getting any of this info because it's on google.com's domain. But imagine that I do click into this. If they don't have any JavaScript at dmv.org that makes me interact with their database, then I could stay on here for 29 minutes and 59 seconds, and then I bounce and I count as a quote unquote bounce. So that's why I wouldn't trust the bounce rate, number one. You can implement with jQuery scroll, I forget, is it scroll? I'm missing a second word there, but like basically scroll JavaScript. This is not remarketing, guys, so get your head out of the gutter. This is not me, this is them. But you can implement jQuery scroll, where like once people scroll past 50% of the page, it triggers an event and it sends it to your database. In which case, if anybody scrolls more than 50%, it's automatically not a bounce, even if I do this and I'm like, screw it, get me out of here. And I actually do bounce. So there's, it's kind of this caveat where like, if it's how to change a tire and I'm going to learn how to change a tire on this page, then I don't need to do anything else. I don't need to like find insurance rates. And a bounce is okay. But if you want me to actually fulfill an action, like sign up for something, like read another page, if there's like a part two or part three, then a bounce is definitely a bad thing. So be aware of that. You can always implement this jQuery thing to a scroll 100%, but if you do scroll 1%, then your bounce rate is going to be nothing, and you're going to think you're a genius, and you might not make any money. So that's what bounce rate is. Exit rate's something else. Exit rate is when somebody performs the same actions as a bounce, meaning they leave your site, however, you are not the first page they've seen. So, for instance, in this place, a bounce rate of 39%. 39.82 on the homepage right here. This means that out of the people that landed on the homepage as the first page on your site, 39.82% left immediately. So like I said before, they might have scrolled all the way down and you didn't have jQuery enabled to track that. They didn't interact with your database, meaning they didn't opt into anything, they didn't view another page, all that good stuff. 40% left before they interacted with the database again. Now, 31.52%, this is a different number. This means the people that came to a different page on your site, then went to the homepage at some point, and then left on the homepage. So this is pretty interesting because, when people come back to the homepage, they come back for a lot of reasons. Like they might have gone to the homepage initially, then they might have gone to the blog and realized that was the wrong thing, or maybe they clicked a link and it incorrectly took them to the wrong place. They came back and then they were like, oh, well, I clicked on the blog link. It took me to the site map or to somewhere else, and I wanted to get back to that initial blog page. However, I don't see another opportunity. I'm leaving. It could also be that, people came in on the homepage, read about every single service page, read your about page, read your careers page, and then they were like, you know what? I don't need this right now. I'm going to come back. It could also be that they left their tab up. So what might happen is they might click on the homepage, they might read it, and then they might get a notification, up here. I'm surprised I haven't seen like a Slack or a push bullet or anything like that. And then I'd click on it and I go to a new page. And then if I go to any one of these and I never come back to your homepage, And then 30 minutes occur, and I quote-unquote exit, or perhaps they shut their laptop because they have to go to a meeting. That counts as an exit too. So an exit is really when somebody quote-unquote bounces, but the page isn't the first page. So you'll see a huge difference between the store and the homepage exit rate. Could tell you something interesting. I think there's a lot of nuances there. Could be completely based on like your site or app's UX. But knowing the difference between exit and bounce and understanding that they're not really a bad thing inherently, that's pretty important too. So let me know if you have any questions about that.